all is quiet on the Androscoggin River as the Bates rowing teams work out on a picture-perfect fall day in Maine. This Sunday, it's about to get loud, very loud, as the Bobcats head to Boston to compete in the 53rd annual Head of the Charles Regatta. And saying there will be a lot of people in attendance would be quite the understatement.
Throughout the race course, you could have as many as 500,000. It covers 5,000 meters. It's in Boston. If it's a nice day, you've got a lot of people that are wandering down there who don't even know of anyone who's racing.
You said 500,000 people come out for it?
Potential, yeah. From top to bottom, it could be as many as 500,000 people.
Senior coxswain Hannah DeBruin is ready for this opportunity. She leads the women's first Varsity 8 boat for the first time in her career.
I feel like a lot of part about being like where I am now is just becoming more mature and like understanding where I fit in with the team and what people want when it comes to coxing. So I think it's just a lot of personal growth.
What people will want from DeBruin and her fellow coxswains on Sunday is different from what they want in the spring. The Bobcats compete exclusively in 2-kilometer sprint races during the spring season. The head of the Charles is nearly 5 kilometers with a variety of twists and turns. You have to steer and you have to be prepared.
I think planning before the head of the Charles is key. Knowing where the course markings are, how to turn and when is important. But other coxswains have also told me to keep my crew calm. I have a lot of rowers who it's their first time rowing the Charles as well. So keeping them calm and focused in on the race is key.
DeBruin's chance to lead the first Varsity 8 boat has been a long time coming. The Bobcats benefited from very experienced coxswains the last 3 years, and DeBruin's rowers could not be more thrilled that now she gets to run the show.
She has just put her heart and soul into this, and I'm just really excited to see what she's going to come up with throughout the course. It's really just going to be, it's almost a performance for her, for us, to be able to listen to what she's going to come up with going down those 20 minutes. I mean, it's just such a wonderful opportunity. She's really earned this.
All the steering makes the head of the Charles a bit of a technical exercise for the coxswains.
You just have to kind of gauge what your boat's like, what kind of pull and effect on both sides, starboard side and port sides, have. And depending on their power, you can also adjust how much effect you should have on your steering as well. It just comes with practice.
Oh, and then there are the bridges. We must not forget the bridges.
Yeah, the bridges are challenging just because you can only fit 2 boats in some of them, and it's really tight. And a lot of the turns are through the bridges, so you have to get it set up perfectly. So you can plan for all you can practice, but then during the actual race, you cannot plan how the other boats will be acting around you.
The head of the Charles is the largest 2-day regatta in the world, with 11,000 rowers in nearly 2,000 boats. The festival-like atmosphere just adds to the excitement.
It's just such a beautiful place to race, and it is such an exciting environment that if you can turn that social aspect from a distraction into a motivation and use it to just feed you and power you the entire way down, you'll never get bored, you'll never get distracted. It's just constant, like, feeding motivation.
So the Bobcat rowers will enjoy the peace and quiet of the Androscoggin River for a couple more days. Then the coxswains will try to steer them to victory in front of potentially 500,000 people. For Bates Athletics, I'm Aaron Morse.